from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Dave Guthrow. Investigators from the state fire marshal's office will be back in Lisbon Falls today trying to figure out what started a fire that killed two young sisters. They do say it was accidental, but are now focusing on two possible causes: a torch that had been used the night before to unplug the bathtub drain and a light fixture located under the tub. The fire broke out yesterday morning at 34 Summer Street. Lorna Hogan and her six children were trapped inside. Witnesses who saw the flames helped the mother get four of the children out, but the bodies of 11-year-old Natalie Hogan and her six-year-old sister Kelsey were found in a second-floor bedroom. Fire investigators and witnesses say the mother, Lorna Hogan, suffered burns and smoke inhalation while trying to save her children.
Yeah, the mother was on the back porch, so we ran to the back porch, and she was passing the kids down off the back porch, and she said there were still two kids in the front bedroom. So I ran to the front, and the oldest son was on the front porch, and he was trying to call his sisters on the cell phone. He couldn't reach, so I ran up the stairs as far as I could, but there was just too much smoke, and the room they were in, it was just totally, the doorway was just totally engulfed in flames. So,
well, last check, Lorna Hogan was listed in critical condition at Central Maine Medical Center. Her four surviving children are staying with the grandparents. Fire officials say there were no working smoke detectors in that house. Well, Stephen Bowen has been officially sworn in as Governor Paul LePage's new education commissioner. The Senate approved his nomination to head the second largest department in state government by a vote of 25-10. Bowen has a master's degree in education and taught for 5 years in Virginia schools, as well as 5 years in the Camden-Rockport district right here in Maine. He then joined the Maine Heritage Policy Center, and after November's election, he went to work for the LePage transition team. Well, high school students from Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont will be on the USM campus in Gorham today to take part in a competition. News 8's Norm Karkos has a preview of the 11th annual Science Bowl.
I'm Norm Karkos here on USM's Gorham campus, the site of the 11th annual Science Bowl. Northern New England teams from Maine, Vermont, and New Hampshire, almost a dozen here from Maine, competing for the top honors, and the winning team will go down to Washington, D.C., of course. They are going to be taking care of questions in a Jeopardy-style manner, the lightning round questions. These young men and women get a chance to answer questions less than 5 seconds, so some pressure's on in biology, chemistry, physics, astronomy, and earth science and math. So it's a great way to expand the mind. The winning team, as we said, will go down to Washington, D.C. This event goes from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. here on USM's Gorham campus. In Gorham, I'm Norm Karkos for News 8 Now.
All right, thanks, Norm. We want to thank you for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Dave Guthrow. Stay with us, and we'll bring you the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. Plus, remember, you can go online to WMTW.com for the latest news, sports headlines, and video, as well as weather forecasts anytime during the day. We'll be right back.